Character creation is one of the most complex processes in 3D modeling. There are 14 main steps to create a full 3D character. Today we will explain these 14 steps one by one, and we will also mention the softwares for every single step that you need to learn. We will also talk about the tutorials that you need to watch and the free and paid courses that you need. So, it's going to be a very helpful tutorial for those who want to become a 3D character artist. So, let's take a quick view at these 14 steps and then we will talk in detail. The concept, where we try to get the reference and the idea of character. Base mesh, where we create a base structure of our character. Modeling and sculpting, where we complete the full structure of character with polygon modeling or sculpting. Re-topology, where we clean our topology with polygon modeling. UV mapping, where we create a 2D map that how the texture will be applied on our 3D character. Baking, it's the process where we bake from high poly to low poly. Texturing, where we apply texture to our character. Rigging, where we add some bones to control our character for animation. Hair grom, it's the process where we create hair for our character. Posing character, where we pose character in a style. Lighting, where we set up a lighting for our character. Shading, where we play with nodes to shade the character. Composition, where we try to fix some of the hue saturation and color problems. And final image, which will be the result of the last 13 steps. So now let's talk in detail. So the number one is the concept. So in this stage we find an idea or a concept of our character. So we can imagine the idea and then we can draw it inside Photoshop, Illustrator, or now you can draw it inside Blender. There is a now 2D mode in Blender, which we can use it for drawing concepts, and you can also use an idea from internet. So there are three main websites for it, which we can use to get an idea or a concept of our character. So the first thing is Google. So we already know about Google, but I will show you some helpful keywords which can help in finding some great stylized reference for your character. So the first keyword is Hethi Swardwa. So it's a famous character artist, concept artist, which is on ArtStation, but if you search this keyword on Google, you will get a lot of his work, and his work are mostly the character concept, so you can get an idea from there. And the second one is character concept, and the third one is the character reference. So you can use these three keywords to find some better character concepts. So the second website is the Pinterest. It's a great website for reference. If you not point some reference in Google, then this one is the second great website that you can find many reference for your character. So just open the website and search anything about character and you will get most of the reference there. So most of the time Google failed to show some images. Then this is the great place. So make sure that you check it out. The third one is the ArtStation. So it's a great website where people put his art to make portfolio, but you can use his portfolio as a reference or a concept of your character. But please make sure to give a full credit to the artist before using his work. There are also some other websites which can be helpful, like texture.com, etc. So the second stage is the base mesh. So in this step we create a basic structure of our character. So there are so many ways that you can create your base mesh, like box modeling, skin modifier, sphere modeling, and many more. I also have a full tutorial on creating base mesh with skin modifier, so you can check it out. The link is in the description. The ZBrush user use pair modeling and the Blender user mostly use skin modifier to create a base mesh. Base mesh can be created in almost any 3D modeling or sculpting software like Blender, Maya, ZBrush, 3D Max, Houdini, etc. And the following tutorials are best for learning 3D base mesh. So jumping to the next stage, which is 3D modeling or sculpting. So it's the process where we complete the shape of our character. So there are two main ways to create the shape of our character. The one is polygon modeling and the second is sculpting. So polygon modeling is the old way and it's pretty much a limited way because we cannot make some complex folds, wrinkles and any other detail. But it's good for some simple characters. And on the other hand, sculpting is the more advanced and more easy way. People use sculpting for creating game characters, animation characters, and also for kinematic characters. So I heard from most of the beginners that sculpting is too hard, but if you try sculpting for like 7 days continuously, then it will work. Just try it every day for 2 hours before sleep and after sleep, and then it will work. That's a little trick for it that most of the beginners struck in it. The most famous and recommended software for sculpting is ZBrush, which have the most powerful and advanced tools. And the second one is Blender. So if you want to learn Blender sculpting, then you should check out my course, which link is also in the description. I have a full course that will teach you how to use all of the sculpting tools, brushes, and some advanced tricks and trips. So the link is in the description. Make sure to check it out. You should also check the Blender Young Sculpt channel for learning Blender sculpting, which is also a great channel for learning sculpting. And if you want to learn the ZBrush sculpting, then you should try the full tutorial of Flipped Normal channel. As you can see it on the screen now. These all are best tutorial for learning ZBrush. So jumping to the next step, which is the re-topology. It's the process where we clean our topology. It's a kind of like creating a nice clean whip on our sculpting mesh. When we finish sculpting, it's really important to do re-topology. Otherwise, you will not able to use this character in games or animations. So the reason why you can't use it, that when you sculpt a character, we get a very high poly mesh and we also get a weird flow of topology. So we also can't rig it. So there are two main ways to do topology. The one is auto topology and the second is by hand topology. So the auto topology is one of the most easy way and you can do it with a few clicks and playing with some setting. But even if you did it properly, you will still not able to use it in animation and it's hardly usable in games. But it's a great for rough use. So there are three software which we can use for auto re-topology. There are many, but we will talk about just three for now. So the one which is on the third place is Blender. Blender have an auto remesh which we can also use it for re-topology. It's not pretty much good for re-topology, but some people use it for. And the second one is the Instant Mesh software, which is a free software and it's pretty much artist friendly and we can use it to create some kind of like automatic topology, but it's also used for as a rough topology. So the first number is the most powerful tool I ever seen. If you use it properly, maybe there is a chance that you can use it in animation too. I mean, like, the result can be very clean. So if you work a bit hard, then you can get something better result. And the tool is ZBrush ZRemesher tool. I use it a lot and I really love it because it works perfect for me at most of the places. So the following tutorials are the most helpful tutorial for learning auto re-topology. Okay, and on the other hand, we have the hand topology, which is a bit harder than the auto re-topology, and it also takes a very long time. But it's too important for those who are serious to learn character modeling. In the end of the manual topology or hand topology, we will get a clean mesh, and we will be able to use it at any place. So for learning the hand topology or manual topology, you need to learn one of the following softwares. So the one is Blender, the second one is the Topcon, which is pretty much new software, but it's really helpful in topology. The third one is Maya. And the helpful tutorial all I found for the manual topology is the flipped normal channel topology tutorial. And also, here are some more tutorials which are pretty much helpful. So jumping to the next one, which is the UV mapping. It's the process where we work on a 2D map of the 3D object, that how the texture will be applied and mapped on our 3D object. So it's a really important step, because without this we cannot texture our character. So first try to learn the UV mapping of some very simple object like cube, sphere, cylinder, cone, etc. So there are many softwares that can be used for UV unwrapping, like Blender, Maya, ZBrush, 3D Max, Houdini, etc. But the most recommended softwares are Blender and Maya. So the next step is baking. So it's the process where we project high poly into low poly. It's only possible if you did the UV mapping or UV unwrapping correctly. Otherwise you will get some weird result. So many softwares can do baking, like Blender, ZBrush, Maya, Substance Painter, Marmoset. But the most recommended softwares for baking are Substance Painter and Marmoset. And the following tutorial can be very helpful in learning baking. The next step is texturing. It's the process where we color our model with the help of real life images or with creating your own textures. So there are three types of texturing. The one is texturing from image, which is also called project painting. So the project painting are mostly used in texturing realistic human for films or high quality games. There are many softwares which can use for project painting, like ZBrush, Blender, and Mari. The second texturing method is the procedural texturing, in which we create texture with a bit more customized way, so we need to play with the nodes and other values. So it's really important, like, you can't find images texture for all the character. So it's really helpful because it's totally customized and artist friendly, and you can create any type of texture that you want. So there are many software which can do procedural texturing. The one is Blender, which have a powerful node setup. The second one is Substance Painter, which are the most recommended one. And the third one is the Substance Designer, which are specially made for this type of procedural texturing. So the third texturing method is the hand painting texturing. It's commonly used method and best for easy and quick result. It's commonly used for a bit mid result, mid realistic results. It's also common for skin texturing and mostly used for stylized characters. But if you work a bit hard on it, it can give you also some realistic result too. So there are many softwares which can do hand painting texturing. The one is Blender, second is ZBrush, and you can also do it in Substance Painter. So now let's talk about from where you can get texture for your character. There are many softwares from which you can get texture, like texture.com and polygon. But if we talk about the skin textures, then it's a bit hard to find it. There is the one famous website for it, which is xyztexture.com, which have a nice and realistic pack of all the texture which are used for skin. So you can buy it, it's not free, but you can also download some of them free on other websites, which you can find it easily if you search on Google. And for learning the hand painting, I would like to recommend the Grant Abbott tutorials to learn from it. There are also other tutorials which I mentioned on the screen. You can see it right now. So jumping to the next stage, which is the hair groom. So it's the process where we add hairs to our character. It can be different in games character and animation character. Because for animation character, we use a particle system for creating hairs. But we cannot use them inside games because it will be so high poly. For games, we used hair cards. Hair cards are the alpha images of real hairs or the image of particle hair. There are many softwares for creating hairs like Blender, which have a strong particle system, ZBrush, which have the fiber mesh, Maya, which have the X-Gen. So now jumping to the next. So if you want to learn the hair groom, the following tutorial can be very helpful. So jumping to the next one, which is the rigging. So it's the process where we add bones to our character to control it for animation. Mostly people get error it because of bad topology flow. It's a bit hard to learn. It can be very easy if you have a simple and low poly character, but it can be very hard if you have an advanced and high poly character. So there are two main softwares for creating or adding bones to a character. The one is Blender, which have a nice and strong system of adding bones, and the one is Maya. So it can be also done with plugins in Blender. Blender have an add-on called Auto Rig, which is not free, it's paid, but it's really helpful for creating fast result. So you can buy it, the link is also in the description. You can also check my tutorial for that plugin. I create a full tutorial on it, that how to use the Auto Rig to create to rig your character. So the link is also in the description, so you can watch that video. So jumping to the next step, which is the posing character. So it can be done only if you done the rigging properly. So it is the process where we pose a character in a style. It can be very easily done if you use some reference for it. So simply search in Google for reference and you will get a lot of reference which can be very helpful. It can be done in Blender and Maya. You can do it with without rigging too. There are some sculpting brushes which can be very helpful. Blender also have a pose brush now, so you can pose it in Blender. And the best one is the ZBrush, which have a very strong pose brush. So it's not need any tutorial. You can do it very easily with following some reference and some Blender basic knowledge. So jumping to the next step, which is lighting. So lighting is one of the most hardest step in character creation, and it need a lot of study about lighting. So if you are a photographer, then it will be a bit easy for you if you done lighting in real life. Otherwise, you need a lot of study for lighting. So there are many softwares like Blender, a plugins from with Maya, which is V-Ray, which is really great for lighting. And if you are a Blender user, then Blender Guru have a very powerful course about lighting, which is perfect for all. If you are beginner or at an intermediate level, you can learn it from Blender Guru. He also create an add-on for Blender. The name is HDRI pack, which have a pack of HDRI and that you can use it for lighting, which is pretty much easy. His tutorial link is also in the description, so you can check it from there. I will also make a video on lighting, so please, if you did not subscribe now, and also hit a like for supporting. So jumping to the next step, which is shading. So it's the process where we play with nodes and some other values like reference value, normal value and other maps values. So Blender have a very strong node setup that we can use it for shading. There are some also softwares which can do it like Maya, but the Blender node setup is also very powerful, so you can use it for it. So to learn shading and Blender node setup, the following tutorial can be very handy. So jumping to the next step, which is the rendering. So it's the process where we capture image from our character, and the best rendering softwares are Marmoset toolbag, which is pretty much easy if you want to make a quick setup for rendering your character. So you can, from there you can get a nice lightning setup, and you can also post process in that. So it's very handy to use Marmoset toolbag. Otherwise, V-Ray is also good in rendering, and Blender Cycle is also a better one. So the last step is the composition. It's the process where we fix some of the hue saturation and color fixing. So the best software is Adobe Photoshop, which have a nice and strong composition setting. But now you can also do it in Blender. Blender have also a strong composition setting now. Okay, so now we will talk about the pre and paid courses that you need to get it. So the first course I will mention about the Blender. So if you wanna learn realistic character in Blender, then the CG master course will be very helpful. The link is also in the description, and you can get it from there. And if you want a stylized or cartoonic character course, then the Young Sculpt have a very great course about character art. So make sure to check it if you are a Blender user. And also make sure that you check my sculpting course in Blender, which link is also in the description. I have a full course on it. And if you don't want to sculpt, then Darian Life have a very nice polygon molding character creation course. So it's a free course available on YouTube. So just search Darian Life Captain Quark in YouTube and you'll find that. So if you want to learn ZBrush realistic character creation, then in the Udemy there is a course named as realistic character modeling for games in